Okay, I think we're live now. This is Matt from XO Pro Tech, and today, as part of our scheduled stream, we are going to be taking apart this Roland V-Synth XT, which has a faulty touchscreen. So, again, there's no, as far as I can tell, there's nothing on here on YouTube that takes it apart. So let's have a look. The Roland V-Synth XT is a really nice synth. Lots of parts, lots of depth to it. The vocoder on it's really nice. Lots of nice presets, etc., etc. But anyway, let's stop me waffling and let's get into it. So just on the base of it. This is actually an access panel. Now, where you can get to some of the main components. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to take this off and just show you. I mean, I don't think it's going to help us in the grand scheme of things, but I just thought I'd show you the innards first. Now, I'm not entirely sure why this access panel, as it were, exists, but because ideally you need to be taking off the main panel really to get into it properly. So yeah. But yeah, when's the last time you actually saw an access panel? So I'm guessing maybe the access panel was probably one of the last things so you could plug all the boards together once you'd got them into the actual units. So, there's quite a lot going on in there. It was a fairly expensive machine when it came out. I believe it was about $2,000 for these units. In fact, that might have been for the keyboard. I think this might have been a bit less, maybe 1,500, something like that. But this is a top-end synth, and hopefully it's sort of retained its value. But it's one of those faults on these machines that's quite well documented, but there's nobody actually, no one has showed you what to do to actually change the touchscreen. But there are a few forums where people have said the same thing and complained about the same fault on these units. And I believe that the Korg Oasis suffers from the same problem as well. I think it might be the same component that they used for their touchscreen. So let's see if we can get a bit more out of here, and let's try and keep everything in view for you as well. If you've watched my Novation video on the KS Rack, you'll know that I've been waiting for some parts and trying to source some parts for it. I rang Focusrite up, who in the UK they deal with Novation, and they're going to be sending me some parts soon, hopefully. Really nice person in the parts department. Knew exactly what I needed, and said no problem. So that's brilliant. I'm probably quite lucky to get the parts. I actually couldn't find the sliding potentiometer anywhere. So props to Focusrite keeping the spares in stock, because they are. I even looked as far as China to try and get them parts in. Okay. So what I'm going to do now is just take off this. This part here, one of the side panels. The rack ears, as it were. One of the nice things about the V-Synth XT, you can actually, when it's in the rack, you can actually move it upwards. So if and then you can move it flat as well. And you know, it's quite good. You can just get it to the angle that you need it without too much of a problem. Sorry, a bit out of view there. So that is the sort of the assembly which holds it into the rack. The rack is completely taken off now. I don't know if I actually needed to take them off, but I thought I might as well. Okay, so underneath those rack ears, let's just see if we can get you get a bit more light in here. Seems to be a bit dark. Okay, that might be a bit better. Yeah, here we go. So we've got a number of screws on this side panel here, which we're going to take out. These were hiding under the rack ears. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 to take off this side part. Possibly another one for this section here. Well, the stream's actually running, because on the YouTube side of things, it literally looks like it's going about two frames a second. Okay, so it was just those five screws there. Get the side panel off. Let's go for the other side. And get it to focus for you guys. With these side panels off, we might be able to just see a bit more into the inner workings of the V-Synth XT. So I should mention as well, in the description and in the title, I've written that what we're going to be doing is changing the touchscreen. Yes, hopefully is probably the best answer I can give. The my only concern is I have purchased this part from China. And I don't actually know if it's the right one, because this is the first time that I've opened up this this synth, so hopefully we have the right one. But you know, if nothing else, it will show you how to open up the V-Synth XT. Hopefully I ordered the right part. So this is the bottom of the V-Synth XT at the minute, and what's quite nice is that everything is labelled up. All the boards, the boards are labelled up. This is the V-Synth jack board assembly, and underneath this cable here it says two inverter board, two main board, two main board. When you're working on when the sort of laptops that I'm normally working on, they don't have the space to give you any of that information. So it's quite nice working on synths sometimes, because it's a hell of a lot easier to trace things. Or sort of, well, let's say larger electronic devices. Where they can actually fit in some nice handy hints and tips, as it were. So, just start camera view there. I think that should be it. Oh, here we go. So this whole back section here comes off, and we are connected in. Okay, so the what we're going to need to do is actually take off a few of these. This is why that back panel was there, because to get into the to all the rest of it, we're going to need to take apart, take out a few of these cables here. So let me show you there. I'm going to need to take out this cable here. So that's just pull out. This one here, again, just pull it out. This one here, just pull it straight out. And I'm thinking that that should release our... Okay, not quite. We also have... okay, let me show you that. What I've just done there. We also need to unplug the... well, let's go on the side view. Just here we have a switch. To actually turn the unit on, we need to unplug the brown cable and the black cable. The black cable, as you look at the bottom of the device, is at the top. The brown cable was at the bottom, as we look. And then what we have as well is, go away, we've also got a those cables there, which are going from the power, leading from the power supply into the unit. Let's take that off the main board. So just that connector there, that's just to pull up. And okay, we've got just one more. My microphone is in the way. One cable at the side here. There we go. We can pull it from either side, but let's just pull it out of that side bit there, and we are free. So this rear section here houses the power supply unit. Let's get that in for you. Also the power in, and it also houses the sort of outputs and the inputs on the rear panel. So we can put that to one side. Now that we're all clear. So the part that we are interested in is buried. As it's... because why wouldn't it be? Underneath all of this here, all of these boards, we've got inverter boards, we've got... what else have we got? We've got main boards, encoder boards. So there is a lot going on here. We just need to be careful about what we're doing and go through it slowly and methodically, as it were. So right, let's take off this board here. This board is... it's got a few Toshiba and Samsung chips on it. It's even got an Epson chip on it, so this is the V-Synth XT mainboard. So I'm assuming the Samsung chips, possibly the Toshiba chips, memory modules for storing everything. And then there's a nice big Roland chip there. That's possibly the sort of brain of the operation, as it were. And all of this was apparently made in Japan, so. Okay, so we need to attach this bit here, which sort of leads to our cardboard. So you can actually put in extra cards. Now so basically what you need to do, just pull up on those side bits there. Release this cable, and we also need to disconnect this bit here. That's in the way. Let's just show you there. Just pull up on it on the cable, and that actually goes to the LCD. So, and we need to disconnect this one here as well. There are two. There are plastic clips just holding it in there, so I might need some pliers just to get that in. I'll give it a good squeeze. No, I've bent it. Damn you, little bit of plastic. Right, there we go. So that is our main board. That is out. Let's put it somewhere very safe. One thing that I'd mention about this extra board thing that's at the front here, the V-Synth, the original V-Synth didn't come with had two extra like cards that you could put into it. They were the DC50 module and the vocoder module. Now the interesting thing about the V-Synth XT is that those modules, those programs actually came inside the V-Synth XT, which kind of makes this part of it redundant. I've never known them release another upgrade for the V-Synth XT. So this actual part, you could take it out quite easily and chuck it on a skip for all I for all that it's worth. It was actually a I don't know if they intended to make more cards for it, more add-ons, but yeah, for the V-Synth XT, it was a waste. It wasn't actually used. So this part here is the V-Synth inverter board. This little cable here is going to the touch panel. So while we are, let me see if I can find the spare part. In fact, I just want to take it out, and it looks, you know, I think we might be in luck here, because I'm just going to take that out. Okay, to take it out, this is to the touch panel. You need to flick these out, two side parts, and the cable will come out. I just want to check the cable on this part. It looks the same, or near enough, then it should work. Cool. Okay, I think we should be okay with that one. So let's take out the inverter board. The inverter board is going to be for the actual LCD itself. Now then, tell you what we'll do. I think there might be an easier way to do this. You know what, let's just, I'll just do it anyway, let's just take the board out completely. But I think there might be a little a shortcut here, because there's a metal plate under here. I don't know if you can just about see it, the four screws in. I'm thinking if I unscrewed those four screws, the whole thing would come out, but for the sake of it, let's just take the whole inverter board out. Okay, and we're going to need to take this bit out here, this cable here, just lift it straight back up, and there's this cable here as well. Again, we're just going to lift that up. And what we're also going to have to do is take out this part here. With the white and pink cables. Okay, so that is the inverter board. Just be careful, there might still be some voltages running around in that, so try not to touch all of it. So yeah, what we could have actually done was just get these four parts here, these four screws, and that would have taken us, that would have been okay for us if we'd taken that out. Without having to undo everything else. Four, and this should just be our touch and LCD here. Okay, this this little cable here is clipped down, so let's just get. Out. Oh my god, how the hell do you get into this? Okay, here we go, I've got it. So this is our culprit here, and wow, it's a really thick piece of glass. It's a really thick LCD module as well. So let's move this this carcass out of the way for now, so we can concentrate on this. I'm going to unpack my touchscreen. It's flown its way all the way from China. So yeah, perfect fit, and the cable seems to be exactly the same length. So let's put it to one side. So, right. The question is now, how do we, let me just reposition this microphone. How are we going to separate this bit of glass? It looks like it is glued down with a bit of tape. The glass, the digitizer that's going to be replacing it isn't quite as thick as what's on here, so... So I think what I'm going to do, I'm going to get some pry tools, and we're just going to sort of go along the edge here and try and pry it off. But you can just about see there are some bits of tape there, some white bits of tape that are sort of holding it on and sort of separating it from the LCD module. So yeah, this has been a fairly involved process just to get to this part. Trying to figure out the best method of approach here, since I've never done one with a full-blown plank of glass on it. Okay, so what I've opted for is a plectrum. That seems to work okay, and it's thin enough just to go under the glass as well. Okay, that. So you could potentially use the metal ones as well. Just be careful because you've got your bare LCD under here. That's why I've gone for the plastic, obviously, because this is an unknown quantity. Ooh. Okay, we're there. So that is our bit of glass off. If I can offer you some advice before you do this, please wear some form of eye protection. You don't want this splintering and going up into your eyes. Bad times. And I'm going to leave that. I'm going to leave that adhesive on because I don't think I have anything that of that sort of thickness. So I'm just going to cheat, as it were, and leave that there. Right. So let's orient our glass the right way. So the way that I have it here, the power to the LCD module is at the bottom. And the replacement glass, the replacement LCD digitizer, that needs to be on your left as you are looking at it, and the power is at the bottom as you are looking at it. Now the cable needs to be so that the metallic pins are pointed downwards to your left hand side as you are putting it back on. As you can see, there are some plastic sheets that we're going to need to take off, otherwise it's not going to work particularly well. So I'm going to take it off the bottom and I'm going to leave the top plastic sheeting on. What I'm trying to do is just figure out where to align it to. And try and align it straight as well. I think we should be okay with that. Now, when I took it out, there did seem to appear to be that there was a bit of a digitizer at the bottom that was sort of hanging there. Okay, my digitizer does actually seem to have some adhesive strips just on the bottom as well. I'm just going to leave that for now. What I'm just going to do is try and line this up as best I can, and then see where we make sure that it's sitting correctly before I fully commit. What you don't want to do is get this glass, this digitizer in the wrong position. Press it all down and then be in a position where you're going to have to rip the digitizer off and potentially totally wreck it. Okay, let's bring that into view. So I've just put the digitizer back in there. I'm just going to screw it down gently. Just make sure everything lines up, as I say, before we fully commit. Okay, so I'm just going to get them bits there. Double check that is sitting okay. That it looks, that it looks flush. And I'm pretty happy with that. So what we're probably going to do now is take off this front plastics, just the protector part of it, and take off those adhesive strips as well, so we can sort of finish off on the job. But yeah, there's quite a lot of parts to this, as you've probably seen, but it is fairly simple to do. You know, there's the only sort of, well, there's not particularly any major challenging parts to it. I guess the only thing to do was getting the right parts in the first place. Okay, cool. So we'll just give that a firm press down. As I say, if you wanted to and you had the spares, you could potentially change the adhesive on the back. I thought that it had still had enough adhesion that it should be okay. So I'm personally going to leave that on and see how we go. Right, let's bring up the carcass again. Well, let's plumb all this back together again and see if it still works. Go away. Right. Do-do-do-do-do-do. So just make sure that your cable is coming up from the right end in there, and make sure that it's not sort of squashed against the side, it's not rubbing on anything like that. Screw this LCD and touchscreen module back in. So yeah, for the now I mentioned that there was a bit of a cheat way to get the whole unit off, obviously by doing these four screws here. Possibly the only problem with that might be that when you're messing around with the touchscreen part and the LCD module, is that you might potentially scratch the inverter board when you're playing around. So it was better to do that part separately. Now which way did this go? Now what we're gonna have to do is thread this bit through the board. Boy. You don't see many products where the LCD cables go through the board. But yeah. Okay, let's plug in our touch panel. Seems to be okay. Let's plug that in, screw that in. Inverter board. And put that in. and that's a pink and white cable can go back in for the LCD. Going there? No, it didn't. Right, this cable here. Go back in here. So yeah, there are a lot of cables that are coming, coming here, there, and everywhere. So let's just you know, make sure that you're getting everything, plugging everything in correctly. And then we've got this cable here. Well, yeah, we need to get that back on that little bit of plastic and screw that back down. I've kind of screwed this on a bit skewy, never mind. It's going to straighten up a bit. And up into there, this one into here, and this big long silver cable, even though we don't really particularly need it, is going back into here. I'm guessing it went that way then. Sometimes you just can't quite tell. I must have something else to plug in here at the back. I think it's just the basically the rear panel now. My goodness, I've lost the rear panel. It's around here somewhere. Here we go. Okay. Switch. Let's just move the microphone again. Turn this back around. Okay, apologies. It's going to be a bit difficult for you to see everything here, but I'm literally just plugging in everything that I that took apart. Well, anything that's sort of showed before, so I'm just plugging in the switch now, making sure I get the brown and the brown and the black wire correct as I remember it. And then we're getting the little ribbon cables in here. Let's put the ones that were loose for our inputs and outputs, etc., etc. Okay, and just remember the parts at the side as well. There's a ribbon cable running down into this sideboard here, which is just out of your view. Let's see if I can show you. I'm just doing the final part. No, it's going to be difficult. It's difficult for me to put in anyway. In fact, let's take that out of that bit. Plug that in to there. Okay. And, get out of the way, microphone. Right, I'm pretty sure that we are all in. Shall we hook this up? Yeah, let's hook it up. But yeah, the only sort of thing to do now for us is really just to screw it all back together, put the access plate back on again, and you know we're sort of good to go then. Unless I've forgotten to put something back in, of course. Or there is potential of problem with something or other component wise. Okay, we have power. The LCD module seems to be lighting up. Okay, so it don't appear to be getting anything on the actual LCD module. Potentially I've missed something out. Probably just the cable. But yeah. Okay, well I think we'll sort of end the stream there anyway. Let's turn that off. There's so many sort of wires and stuff. I'm going to go back through it and just have a quick look, make sure that I can get that issue resolved. But we definitely had power to the LCD. We just looked as if we didn't have the video connection, which could be, as I say, it's probably a cable somewhere that's not quite sitting right, or potentially I've put it in upside down, potentially something like that. Yeah, that is how to change the glass, the digitizer, the touchscreen on a Roland V-Synth XT. My name is Matt from XL Pro Tech. Thank you very much for watching. If this has helped you, there's a link in the description if you want to support the channel. You can do. Okay, thank you very much for watching. Bye-bye for now.